balancing of the clouds. And we read that. We read about the balancing of the clouds in Job 37, verse 16. Dost thou know the balancing of the clouds, the wondrous works of him which is perfect in knowledge? Now, you might take clouds for granted, but if you were a weather forecaster, you would realize that it's not a job that you can be 100% sure of what's going to happen tomorrow. You can predict what's going to happen, but sometimes the rain comes and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes the snow comes, sometimes it's a cloudy day. You just don't know for sure what's going to happen tomorrow. But God knows. Slide number 2 says, He, and this is Job 37:13, He causes it, the cloud, to come, whether for correction or for his land or for mercy. Next slide is this picture of a tornado. Next slide, slide 4, dost thou know the balancing of the clouds? And you can see this huge cover of clouds over the city in this particular slide. Next slide, hast thou with him spread out the sky, that's in verse 18, and there's a pretty picture of either sunset or sunrise. Now, the items you need for this little science demonstration are simple. You can do it right now at home. You just need a clear drinking glass, the taller the better, because you need more water for what we're doing. And you need water, and you need ink, or food coloring that you can just drop out a tiny drop. And we're going to use food coloring, but it's important once you fill your glass that you let it set for at least a minute so that any swirling in the water, it's all settled down and not moving, because we're going to put a drop of coloring in it, and we only want the color to move and not the water itself. And we're going to start with the glass, but we can't bump the table. We can't do anything that will make this glass. I have a glass of water, and then I have a quart jar of water. Now, what I'm going to do, when I put this one drop carefully, without disturbing the table, without disturbing the glass, or even the surface of the water, I want to put it in as carefully as I can. I'll let you do it in a minute. But what's going to happen, I know, what's going to happen is going to happen like in a split second. So the first time around, it's hard to see. But what's going to happen is a ring of color is going to form in this water, a ring. And then that ring will become unstable and break into more rings. And those rings break into more. And it keeps going until it hits the bottom of the glass or the color becomes too diluted. And I'll explain why this happens. But when you see this, you're going to have to watch carefully. The first time I did this, I thought, that doesn't look right, but it is right. So I'm going to get my drop of color here. You might want to come close to see it. Can she come close in? To watch. Now I hope I don't mess this up. See the ring? Now it's breaking into more rings, and each of those rings are breaking into rings, and it's going to happen all the way down. Each ring becomes unstable and breaks up into other rings. And it's slowly working its way down. Now that might look like a cobweb to you, or some kind of mixture, but really, if you look from the top, you can look down and see those rings. Oops, try not to shake the table. Come on up, sweetheart. But they are working their way down. Now, if you're doing this at home, is it diluting? You can do it again in this very same glass.
In the same glass.
We're going to try again, and then we're going to try in this...
Can I do this?
You can do it. Now, the thing of it is, don't touch the table, and don't let it drop from up high, because then it will kind of disturb the water. Just put it as close to the surface of the water as you can. And then we have to watch the rings. Can you see them, Ashley?
Yes.
We'll do a different color in the I hope someone's doing this at home because it's kind of fun to watch. And the taller the glass, the slower this happens, so you can watch it.
Can we do two at the same time?
Yes, Ashley wants to try two at the same time, so we will. Do you need some help?
No.
You think you can do it? Come on, Miss Scientist. Let's see what happens here. Not too high up. It has to be as close to the surface as possible. Oh, look at that ring. It really went down. It lasted for a long time, Ashley. I don't know what you did, but you did very good. Very well. Oh, I wish we had another jar. I want to see that again. That blue ring sunk as a ring. It stayed stable for at least a second before it started breaking up. There it goes. Isn't that neat? Okay, now, the reason I'm telling you all of this, let's move on. The reason I'm telling you all this, slide 7 tells you the procedure. It's something you can do at home. Slide 8 tells you what happens. I think that's 8. Yes, the color will slowly sink because it's a little heavier than the water. So it sinks, and as it sinks, it forms a small ring in the water. Now, the shorter the glass, the faster it happens, but a tall glass makes it, this time, when Ashley did it, it went really slowly down and it kept its shape. This ring eventually breaks into smaller rings, and scientists are not completely sure why this happens. Slide 9. But what we do know is, as the ring falls through the water, the outside of the ring falls slower than the inside of the ring, and this causes the ring to slowly rotate. And when it rotates, the fluid inside the ring rotates faster than the surface of the ring, and this keeps it in its shape for a while until it soon becomes unstable and breaks up. But when it breaks up, new rings form. The same process happens, and it keeps happening till the rings hit the bottom of the glass or the color becomes too diluted. Next slide. Just as the rings swirl around in the water, the atmosphere outside, where the clouds are, what we breathe, it swirls and moves and mixes. And just as the scientists don't understand what happens in that glass with these rings breaking up, they don't completely understand what happens in our atmosphere. The meteorologists can't predict with 100% accuracy the weather you will have tomorrow. Only God knows completely how the clouds and the atmosphere work. And what happens with fluids, just like we saw in our little science demonstration. So the demonstration today is to help you understand that something as small as a drop of coloring in a glass of water is so complex that scientists have a hard time explaining it or understanding it. But God is the author of all of the physics we know, all of the laws of nature, and controls our atmosphere also. We don't know. I'm looking at slide 12, the balancing of the clouds. We don't understand that, but we can know He who holds it in His hand and holds them in His hands. And here's a pretty picture of some flowers, but lots of clouds in the background. Until next Sabbath, may God bless those of you who are watching on our little science demonstration video.